Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and welcome back to another Next.js video. In this video, we are going to deal with the loading UI. Well, let's say you fetch some data from an API. Usually this process takes time, but if your website has a well-designed loading animation or loading skeleton, then it enhances the user experience. In this video, we are going to see how to set up the loading UI screen in Next.js 13. So without any further delay, let's get started. I started a Next.js app and these are my default settings for this project. Next, I opened the app in Visual Studio Code, but before writing any code, let's run this project using the command npm run dev. Okay, this is the default rendering of the Next.js app. Now if you go to the page.js file which is inside the app directory, you will find the default code of Next.js. This is the code of what we saw just now in the browser, but we are going to delete this code. First, we are going to add a header. We will use Tailwind CSS to style it a bit. This looks fine. Change the dark theme to light in the global.css file. Cool. Now make a dashboard folder inside the app directory and inside that folder make a JavaScript file named page.js. Here I am going to add a dashboard component. Inside this component, we will also add a header for the dashboard page. Now to navigate to the dashboard page from the home page, we will use the useRouter hook. It is used for navigation. You can read more about it in the official docs. You can see that our button is working fine. We can easily navigate to the dashboard page on button click. But before rendering the dashboard page, we are not seeing any loading animations, right? The navigation is almost instantaneous. Now we will add a loading.js file inside the dashboard directory. The special file loading.js helps you create meaningful loading UI. With this convention, you can show an instant loading state from the server while the content of a route segment loads. The new content is automatically swapped in once rendering is complete. Now to add a custom loading UI animation or skeleton, you can use the custom CSS styles for it. For example, you can create a file called dashboard.module.css inside the dashboard directory. The .module.css extension is used for custom CSS files in Next.js. Now quickly I am going to add some CSS stylings. Perfect. Now, use the CSS styles in the loading.js file. Now if you refresh the page and click on the dashboard button, you will see a loading skeleton for a fraction of a second. The dashboard screen only has a header to render, so the loading skeleton is not visible for long. However, if you are fetching data from an API, such as the OpenAI API or Google's Palm API, this loading technique would improve the user experience. I hope this is clear now. Well, that's it. I hope this video will help you with your project. If you have any issues, feel free to reach out to me. You can comment here or DM me on my social media handles. The links are down below in the description. Thanks for watching and see you in the next Nextjs video.